Hello guys, welcome to ITS, Information Technology Skills. So, for today's video, start po natin yung beginner's tutorial po natin on how to create your first program using C# programming language. Okay? So, but before we start, mag-overview muna tayo kung ano ang C#. Okay? C# is intended as a simple general purpose object-oriented programming. Okay? So, ginawa po siya para sa object-oriented programming. Ibig sabihin po nun, gagawa ka ng mga object dun sa book, sa program mo. The next, it is developed by Anders Helsberg and his team during the development of .NET framework. Okay? So, a bit of history lang yun. The next, there are different types of C# program. First, we have the console application. This application runs from the command line. So, ibig sabihin, pag console application, nagra-run po siya sa command line. Ito po yung black and white na output. The next, we have the Windows form application. This take advantage of the graphical user interface or GUI provided by Microsoft Windows. Okay, so pag sinabi naman nating Windows Form Application, ito po yung gagawa ka naman ng GUI or Graphical User Interface. GUI po guys, these are the objects na pwedeng gamitin ni user like the button, text box, and so on. Okay, so for Windows Form Application, gagawa po tayo later on. So don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell para po updated kayo sa mga bagong videos. Next, we have the web services. These are routines that can be called across the web. From the word web services, ito po yung mga plugins dun sa web na pwede nating gamitin. And next, we have the web form or ASP.NET application. ASP.NET applications are executed on web server and generate dynamic web pages. So, ano ba yung mga structures or the program structure of a C#? First, we have the comment. The next, you have the using system, the namespace, the class, method, and other parts. So, now let's discuss kung ano yung mga structure na nasabi kanina. The using system. Using is a keyword highlighted with blue by the editor. The using keyword imports a namespace and a namespace is collections of classes. Okay, so ginagamit po natin yung using system or yung word na using para po mag-import ng mga kailangan natin dun sa program. Okay, so later on makikita nyo medyo madami tayong iba't ibang using. The next, we have the namespace. Ano nga ba yung namespace? It is a collection of classes. So, pag sinabi natin namespace, these are the classes na bumubuo dun sa program natin. Ano nga ba yung class? These contain the method. So, yung class naman, siya naman po nagko-contain ng method. Ano yung method na sinasabi? So, we have the main method. This states what the class will do when executed. So basically, pag sinabi nating method, ito yung mga actions na ginagawa nung class kapag na-run na po siya. The next, we have the comment. It is a line or lines of code enclosed with the following symbol. Double backslash for single comment. Backslash and asterisk for multiple comments. Okay, so ano yung comment? These are part of your program na nilalagay natin dun. Pero hindi po siya nire-read ni compiler. Ibig sabihin, hindi siya mag-a-affect dun sa program. Lalagay mo lang dun para magsabi ka dun na definitions. Just like the definition or what part of the program, kung anong gagawin niya dun. But it will not affect the program. So, now let's try some basic input and output for your first consult program. So ngayon, gagawa tayo ng consult program. Black and white po muna ang output natin. Okay? So in writing a consult program, we need the word consult. The next, we have a method, write and write line. So this is output. So pag sinabi natin console.write or console.write line, magdi-display tayo or magpapakita tayo ng output. Now, try to write this on your program. You can use Visual Studio para po maggumawa ng C# program nyo. So, pag wala pa po kayong idea ko anong Visual Studio, lalagay ko po sa link sa baba yung tutorial natin ng Visual Studio. So, meron din tayong read line. Try to write it on your program. So, ano yung read line? Read line naman, guys, this is use function to suspend the console. So, ibig sabihin, magra-run yung program, masusususpend, hindi siya magkuklose agad. Okay, so yun yung read line. So, mamaya makikita natin anong gamit ng read line. So, your program must look like this. So, if you're going to observe, madami ka tayong using dito. Yun yung pinakauna yung using system. Okay? So, ito, default na itong magpapakita kapag ginamit nyo po yung Visual Studio C# program. Then, next, we have the namespace. Yung namespace po, guys, ang katabi po niya is the name of your program. Then, next, we have the class. Then, the main method. The static void main, that is the main method. So, ibig sabihin, pag nira natin yung program, magkoconsole.write siya, I can C#. Then, meron tayong read key. So, if once you run the program, the output must look like this. Okay? Next, try to edit your program, remove read key, console.read key. Okay, so if you run your program, mabilis na siyang magpapapap and magkuklose. So, ibig sabihin nun, guys, hindi sira yung program yun. Wala siyang error. Ibig sabihin nun, hindi siya nasuspend. Nag-run siya, then nag-close siya agad. Walang suspend. Okay? So, yun yung gamit ng read key. So, every time na magpro-program kayo gamit ang C# console application, ang pinakalas na program nyo is the read key. Next, try to edit your program. Write this code. Your code must look like this. Then, if you run your program, ganito pong output. Okay. So, ba't naging ganun? Let's go with the code. Kung makikita nyo, meron tayong write. Ano yung difference ng write and write line? Kanina, write line ang ginamit natin. Makikita natin ulit kung ano yung difference. Try to edit your code. Change console.write, I can C# to console.write line, I can C#. Then, try to run your program. Your output must look like this. So, anong nangyari? Bumaba yung now. Ang different ng write line sa write. Ang write line, guys, gagawa siya ng enter or magne-next line po siya after printing the word. Kaya po, nag-enter now. Nag-enter po yung now. Nasa baba na po siya. Kasi after printing, I can C#, gumawa si console.write line ng enter. Okay? Now, let's try to have input value. Okay, so meron tayong read line. Kapag po mag-i-input tayo ng value, ibig sabihin kukuha tayo ng value from the user, gagamit po tayo ng read line. Okay? So, ang ine-enter po natin pag read line, always string, data type. Pag sinabi nating data type, ito yung type ng data na ina-accept niya. Okay? So, data type will be discussed on the next video. So, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell para updated kayo sa next videos. We have this sample. Try to write this code on your program. So your program must look like this. If you're going to run your program, ganitong unang magpapakita. It will ask you to enter your name. So meron kang makikita diyang insertion point. Magta-type po kayo diyan ng name nyo. Then after typing your name, hit enter para po mailagay yung string natin. So after hitting the enter, so for example, I type ITS Infotech Skill, I hit enter. It will print again my name. Okay, so ganun lang siya, guys. So that's it, guys. You've made your first program using C# programming languages. Don't forget to subscribe. Hit the notification bell for more tutorial videos. Bye!